The first thing you need to do is create a blank spreadsheet. Then click Extensions and Google Script and copy the code from the description of the video. I am not going to explain each row of the code, but I have added comments that explain what each line of the code does if you want to play around with it. Next, save your script and head back to the spreadsheet. Now we need to create our headers. Just remember that if you order the columns differently, you're gonna have to change the references in your script. The next step is to add our buttons. For this, I use the images that I added in the description of the video, but you can use any images or drawings. Now that we have our buttons, we need to link each of them to one of the functions in our script. To do that, we click on the image, the three dots, and click Assign a Script. And then we write the function name of each of our functions. The last thing we need to do is create a tab for each month. In this tab, we're going to have a column for the dates, a column for each project, and a column for the totals. Using the formula I provided in the description, we're gonna subtract the start times from the end times and combine them using sumifs to each of the projects so we know how much time you worked on each project and in total per day of the month. Now, by clicking the green button, you create a new row in your table for a start time, the red button an end time, and a new row if you want to manually enter your data. You can also optionally select the project you're working on in order to have a breakdown in your time. The result of the work time will automatically show up in your month tab. If you don't want to have to resort to Google Sheets to track your working time, maybe you should try Kanbanchi. It has an integrated tool for time tracking, as well as a Gantt chart, a Kanban board, and much more. I hope this video has helped you, and I'll see you in our next Kanbanchi tutorial.